Ever since I was young, I've had a dream of seeing penguins. And while penguin sledding might not be an option, although I really, really wish it was, I still had my eyes set on going to this part of the world. What was Patagonia really like? Would the mountain range on everyone's jacket live up to expectations? Well, we were on a mission to find out. Just two heartbroken boys whose combined 5 years of relationships had coincidentally ended the week prior, well, they were headed to the bottom of the world, with only one thing getting in their way. Food poisoning.
Do you want to go and just like see that here?
No, I think I'll go.
Let's just do it. Let's not risk it.
It's 1:30 in the morning. I just woke up and puked my guts out. Thank you. But we have to leave in like an hour. I've never felt so bad. It's okay though. It's part of the experience. We'll remember this for sure.
And well, just like that, we were off. Two boys who were already down bad enough were now horrendously down bad with food poisoning. But a great adventure lied in front of us.
I've never felt this bad in my life. But we're going. It's the only way to see the penguins.
It had taken every ounce of strength to get to the airport, and I think we all felt a mix of relief and, wait, why are we doing this again? It would have been much easier just to stay in Buenos Aires, but I guess we didn't come all this way for nothing. And there we were, three boys headed to their hostel in the back of a taxi with no idea what was about to unfold next. But welcome to Patagonia, the end of the world. We are staying in the city of Ushuaia, which, fun fact, is actually the southernmost city in the entire world. It's one of 5 internationally recognized Antarctic Gateway cities, and the word Ushuaia means deep bay. The air was crisp, the mountains were calming, and the architecture was quaint. As my friend Simon says, nature heals.
Every hour, dude. For a 4-hour flight, I spent an hour in the bathroom in the airplane, bro.
Dude, I was so worried that I was gonna shit my pants that I put.
We stuffed our underwear with toilet paper.
What'd you eat? Empanadas.
Yeah. Holy crap, dude.
Yeah.
What a journey. Send me pictures of the penguins.
Yeah, we will.
Appreciate it, boys. Yo, have fun today. Have fun.
When we got back to the hostel, we found out that we'd made a huge mistake. All the penguin tours were booked until Thursday, and we were leaving on Tuesday. We'd spent thousands of dollars to go to the bottom of the world and to be so close to fulfilling a childhood dream of mine, but at the last moment, we weren't able to because we'd overlooked a very, very simple part of planning. It was looking like that was a reality I had to accept. How could I have forgotten the most important part of all this? It felt silly that, I don't even know, like how? But the optimistic part of me said that we should at least show up tomorrow at the port and see if anyone would let us on our boat. Why not give it one last shot since we were here?
Night 1 in the hostel. feeling a bit better.
Yeah. Ryan, how you feeling?
I feel very weak, but I just took some Tylenol, so hopefully, things will be better.
Michael, what's the plan for today? What are we about to go do?
We're gonna go to see the penguins, actually. We're gonna have fun, hopefully try to see them in the island, you know, and take cool pictures.
Let's go. Yeah. It's a big day.
It's a big day.
The big day's finally here. We're here, but the line is so long. Oh no. We should have planned this better. We're here, but
what is it?
I don't know.
Ask space for today. I'm missing this one. I'm gonna ask another of them.
Okay. What do you think?
Huh? I don't know what's going on.
All right, we're cutting it so close. Oh my god. I thought it was over. I was so worried. Looks like we found a way.
Let's go. Let's go.
I threw all the food poisoning and everything. We just here, man.
Oh my gosh.
Feels so good to be here.
How do you feel? How do you feel?
Nah, I'm just happy, man. I can't even explain how I'm feeling. It's just like we've been through so much to get here that it's magic now.
Yeah.
Oh shit, the white shit of the bird. Yes. Oh, mira, como se pita.
Look at that penguin.
Oh my god.
It's just like laying on the ground.
And well, would you look at that? Despite all the odds, we made it to the bottom of the world just to see these small little cute creatures. It felt good. It felt really good.
We actually made it here. I thought we wouldn't be able to see the penguins because he said everything was booked until Thursday and our flight leaves Tuesday morning. So I was like, no way we went across the whole world and wouldn't be able to see the penguins.
Right, yeah. Doing
all of them.
There are like a lot of them.
Did you use my fucking sock to clean your camera lens?
It worked.
Okay.
Hey, you gotta do what you gotta do.
It was our last day in Patagonia, and we heard a rumor about a remote post office that would actually stamp your passport. So we headed out on one last adventure.
Michael, how you feel?
Good.
Shut the fuck up, bro.
I'm dead.
Or do we have to walk?
Michael, yeah. What did you just do?
No, I just was spreading the word of God too. You know, to Max and Ryan.
The word of God?
Yeah.
What the fuck? Where'd that come from?
No way.
Everything started to slow down for me as I sat in the back of that car and finally had a chance to reflect upon how spontaneously beautiful this trip had come together. It felt bittersweet. Argentina was one of the most mentally challenging trips I've ever been on. Just the constant pit in my stomach from heartbreak made it a real battle to remain present in the moment. But by just pushing on, I knew things would get better. It sounds cliche, but they did. And to think that just one optimistic DM from Michael would turn into this whole grand adventure, it's just beautiful. It's honestly beautiful. It makes me smile to think about. So, wherever you are in the world right now, whatever is scaring you or holding you back, I hope you can find a way to keep moving forwards and to continue being optimistic about whatever life throws your way. You got this.
At 7, I would say 7, so it will be more reasonable. Man, these are the last moments that we're having together.
How do you feel?
I'm feeling pretty sad, to be honest, but grateful at the same time. So, yeah. That's how alive it is, man.
Sad that this like trip is coming to an end.
Oh, me too, man. Don't even say that. I'm gonna cry for you.
I feel like I know you so well now.
Yeah, of course. I feel the same. We've just been the 7 days all together, and I feel the same, of course. We're just like brothers now. Yeah.
Can you believe that, dude? Like, we're in fucking Patagonia. Thank you.